With us now, Dude Who Shot Said Video, Shlomo Alfassa is live with us here in studio. You say this isn't the first time, and that these bus drivers' hands are not on the wheel often.
No, I've seen it before. And today I've spoken with other people who, from the public who I've never met, who wrote to me saying that they witnessed the same actions, this tearing of tickets and eating and being on the cell phone.
You mentioned to me that at the Boston Globe, where they did a story on this, in the comments section online, a lot of people are using the word intimidate when describing these drivers. And sure enough, I looked it up and they are.
Yeah, there is a lot of intimidation that goes on.
How does a bus driver intimidate you?
They start by putting their luggage on the seats behind them. It's a very commonly known thing.
So you won't sit behind them?
So you won't sit behind them. You won't observe what they're doing. And then if you ask them, they bark at you. I've taken probably 30 buses in the last year, and because I don't like to drive up north.
Yeah.
And there is an intimidation factor. You
so
don't want
weird.
To talk to the bus drivers. You do not want. You're scared they're going to let you off on the street somewhere, and you'll be stuck.
This guy appears to just be sort of going through bills or something.
These are tickets.
What is deciding that the bus stays between the lines? His knees?
I don't know. I think the bus just has a good alignment, but I don't believe the steering wheel is low enough for his knees to hit it. He's a very short man. I noticed when he got up at the end.
This just does not look. I don't know. I mean, from just looking at it, I'd be afraid to be on the Peter Pan.
It really was scary. And I was concerned for everybody on board. At one point, I turned the camera around so you could see all the people on the bus. I don't know if it's in this clip.
I don't know.
But the people who were sitting around me also observed this.
And you've talked to transportation officials. Obviously, this is a private bus company, Peter Pan. And they have put the guy off the road for a while they check into it.
They did. And the vice president of safety called me yesterday trying to reassure me now after the fact, after a month of me trying to reach them, that they're going to do something about it. I hope he does. I don't know if he's going to. They've been extremely difficult to reach. This happened on April 9th, and since April 9th, I've called 5 times. Hmm. I even called a 1-800 number, which led to a voicemail, and that was the safety hotline.
It was Peter Pan himself, or herself, as it were.
I'm not sure.
You know, what is it with Boston? I mean, not only can Big Poppy not hit the ball, but everybody in Boston seems to text message when they need to be driving.
I kind of like Big Poppy.
Oh, I like the Big Poppy, too, as long as he's not hitting the ball. But you know what I mean? It's going on a lot in Boston these days.
Yeah, I was an EMT for a long time, and I know that accidents happen, and they do happen. And there's a huge potential here. And I feel what I did was hopefully mitigate something like this by bringing it to their attention. I don't look for the driver to be fired.
Right.
What I look for is the company to take responsibility. And the problem is, they, like a lot of corporate America, they blocked off communication. You can't reach them.
Right, it does
happen.
They
don't want to talk to you.
Shlomo Alfassa, good luck. We'll keep on this.
Great.